Hey guys, so today now Sony has unveiled their new phone, their new Sony Xperia phone, a new flagship device, and it is the Sony Xperia Z1, also known or been known like in a code name of Honami. So this phone, let's just go over all of the new stuff. So first of all, 8.5 millimeters in thickness. I can probably make a more in-depth video compared more in detail about the Xperia Z, but we're gonna get the Galaxy, a new Froggy Note phone here pretty soon. So I am just gonna go over this a little bit quick. It's a new sensor, a f2.0 Sony G lens with a Sony XMR RS sensor, a Sony Bionz image processor. What else? Yeah, 20 megapixel camera, which sounds totally insane. 1080p video, we got the rumors that it would be 4K, but that's not the case. They also have a new camera app, manual controls, augmented reality features. And then it also shares the Xperia Z's features that it was slim, water resistant. So that is good. 5-inch 1080p display, which should be about the same as the Xperia Z. Maybe the Xperia Z didn't have 1080p. Oh well. Android 4.3, so the latest version of Android, or now we have the new Android 4.4 KitKat version coming out, but hey. New Snapdragon 800 chipset, so extremely nice. It's gonna have kind of like the same chipset as the Galaxy Note 3, so very good. They also have improved the display from what I can see from the Xperia Z, so they fixed that problem. Battery capacity also needs to be up a lot, 3000 milliamps, which sounds extremely good here. And then the 4G phone, of course, black, white, and purple, and that this Sony Xperia Z1 will be available this month. And then they also did unveil these kinds of Sony Cybershot QX100 and QX10 lenses that you will be able to attach on your iOS or Android device, which it's exciting. They're gonna be kind of expensive, but pretty insane. So let's just take a look at some pictures here. First of all, it seems like it has a better design overall, if you ask me, than the Sony Xperia Z, especially on the sides. It seems to be a lot more curved, and it just looks better. It looks like they've been thinking over the material a little bit on the sides, which is good. Still, glass back, that could be a problem. That could be a problem if because the Sony Xperia Z did have an edge to the phone, so when you put it on a glass surface, it didn't move around. It doesn't seem like this one is featuring that, so if it moves around, has a glass back, then that kind of sucks hard. But we'll see about that, we'll see about that. This is the colors, purple, white, and black, and looks good, especially the purple edition. I do like those special colors. And here we also do see, we can probably see that the lens on the back side looks a little bit bigger, display better, so it doesn't have those problems, the viewing angles problem that the Sony Xperia Z had. I mean, that was a huge failure. And it seems like they also optimized the buttons a little bit to better quality. And yeah, this looks good. This looks good. It's a glass back. But I'm a little bit worried here that if it's a full glass back that it will move around. Maybe not. Maybe if it has this kind of edge here on the side, because that would be annoying as hell. And then here we do have the Sony Cybershot lenses that you will be able to attach from what it seems to be on both iOS and Android devices, but one of these would cost around 500 euro or bucks, so that's a lot of money. That's a lot of $500, that's a lot of money. But this one looks cool. I mean, this one looks extremely fresh. Yeah, so just a quick little video covering that. We're gonna get the Galaxy Note very, very soon. So stay tuned for that. Gonna get it today. Peace out. Or at least you see it, at least. Yeah, have a good day.